In this video, we're going to be taking a look at downloading content in Box. You can access Box by going to tufts.box.com and logging in with your Tufts username and password, which I've already done. And I'm going to go ahead and click into one of these folders. So I'm going to go into this sandbox folder here. Now, when we're talking about downloading content in Box, what we mean is that we are taking something that is saved to our Box account, so it's saved to the cloud, and we're saving a local copy of it to our own device, so to your laptop, for example. And there are multiple ways that you can do this in Box, which I'll demonstrate for you. And you have the ability to download whole folders like this one here, as well as individual files, and you can also download multiple items at once. So for example, if I wanted to download maybe this brainstorming session document, I could right-click on that, and then I could select download from the menu that pops up. I could also highlight an item by clicking on this white space here, so as you can see now it's colored in a little darker blue, and some buttons pop up at the top of the screen, and one of those is download, so I could click on that. And if I wanted to download multiple items that way, if I hold down the shift key and click on another item, as you can see now, multiple items will be selected between the two that I clicked on, and I could click on download to begin downloading all of those items. Finally, another thing that you could do when you're looking through your file list or if you're in a file preview window is you could find the more options button, these three little dots, and you could click on that and then select download from there. So I'm going to go ahead and download this brainstorming session document by clicking on download. My computer is going to ask me where I'd like to save it to, so I'm going to say save it to my desktop. So my computer is doing that, and as you can see here on my desktop now, that brainstorming session document has been saved. And once again, I can click into this to open it up, and it'll open that in the desktop version of Word. I just want to remind you again that this is a local copy now. It's no longer covered by Box's security protections, and any changes that I make are not going to be synced to my Box account. So if I make any edits to this and I save it, those edits are going to be saved to that local copy that is living on my desktop. But now if I look into the file preview here for the copy that's saved on Box, as you can see in the file preview, those edits do not show up. So what I have on my desktop is a local copy that is not the same as what I have stored to my Box account anymore. That link has been broken. So that's downloading in a nutshell. You can also upload content to Box, which means that you are taking content from your local device and storing it to the cloud, to your Box account, which we cover in another video that I will be putting the URL for on the screen. Thank you for watching this video on downloading content from Box. If you'd like more information, you can go to the Box service page at access.tufts.edu/box.